Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about Power BI services and how to sign up in Power BI services so that you can use Power BI service to deploy and share your reports. Let's see what is Power BI services. It is meant for deployment of your reports, whatever you developed in Power BI desktop, and to create your dashboards. It's used for sharing and collaboration of your reports with other users. Meaning like you have a Power BI desktop that sits in your system, you cannot share and collaborate with other users. If you want to so, then what you have to do is you need to share the Power BI X file and they need to download the Power BI desktop in order to see the report. That is not the right way to do it, because as end users, they want to see only the report. They don't want to use the development tool like Power BI desktop. So this is the place where once the developer or user or technical person who develops the report in Power BI desktop and he deploys in Power BI services so that it can be shared across business users. This is also called as Power BI Online, and it is considered as a software as a service in terms of cloud technology. So with this introduction, let's deep dive into Power BI services. Before jumping into next topic, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in Power BI. We already know what are the different parts or architecture of the Power BI. So we have Power BI desktop. We have seen a lot of videos behind that. If you haven't seen that, just watch my Power BI Basics Advanced playlist so that you will understand what you can do it in Power BI desktop. Today's main focus is on Power BI services, where you see you develop the reports and publish it here in the cloud. And using your gateways, you can able to access. In this video, we are going to focus on creating your account in Power BI services, and we'll try to deploy a single report. That is the main agenda of this video. And you can able to access the mobile. That is, we will see it in later videos. So before moving into a demo, I just want to make everyone to understand like there are two paths in Power BI. The Power BI service is available in cloud, and you also have Power BI services on premises. What are the main difference? So the desktop is here and you can deploy and share for collaboration. You can go for cloud version. All your reports sits in cloud, and people everywhere, whoever have access, they can access it from any devices across the globe. On another flow, you have a Power BI desktop on premise and you dedicatedly own the Power BI server on your environment, meaning you have dedicated server for it and you install Power BI services as a software in that server. Then you can deploy your reports in that server. So mostly if your data is so secure, some government agencies, some banking industries, those who think like they have the secure data to not go and sit in the cloud, they will use these options. Maybe it depends, okay? So these are the two flavors of Power BI that most of them aren't aware. That is what I want to highlight. One more important thing is, for Power BI, some people think like Power BI desktop is same, then you can switch to cloud and report server. It is not the case. Power BI desktop is also available in two flavors. While you are downloading, it is by default, it is Power BI cloud. When you work on Power BI services on premises, then you need to dedicatedly have the Power BI desktop for on premises. There is a separate installation for this. Both have a different things. We will see what are the different features that are missing in on-premises compared to cloud, and those things we will see it in later videos. Without wasting time, let's jump into a demo. Right, so basically you need to have a user account, that is work or school account. Maybe I'll write it here, work school account, meaning like you should have email with something designated as company name.com, something like that. Your Gmail or your Yahoo mail won't work. So if you have your general personal emails, that won't work here. Let us see that in separate video, how to create one. Now I'm going with some company name.com. I mean, if I have some info at company name.com. So for this demo, we'll stick to this. This is one of the prerequisite to deploy it in online. Let us sign in. Powerbi sign in. Okay. Let's search it in Google. You headed to first email. I mean, first search result. Okay. That's good. Now, so here you have already have an account. You can sign in. Just scroll down. Then you have sign up and get started today. Sign up for free or become pro user for even more storage and BI tools. Let us sign up for free. Those who are learning, it will be really good. This is my email address. Let us give that, use it for free. Then it will prompt me for a number. Let us try to choose country. Let me check. Okay, it's not searching. It's very, very bad. There is no search feature. Give you a number, then choose either call or text me. I want to go for text me. Once I get a message, then just keep that. You hear that sound? I got a message. 691. Okay, then that's all. So you need to give other information. Did you get your email address from your company? Yes, this is one of the company. So just give your name. This is Naga and last name KG. Create password. Give some password. Give some tough password. That combination of your uppercase, lowercase. I hope most of them ever. Okay, and we sent. You need to verify your email as well. So there you go. You got email here. So this is the subject. So take that one. So if you have a company email, you need to give that one. And give your country. That's it, guys. So I think we have given then you accept the agreement and click on start. So this is basically creating your account in the Power BI online. I usually don't save password. So if you have more people here, it will send them some email. So for now, I'm skipping it. So that those people can be invited and they can also able to share. I mean, if you deploy a report, then you can share. That is the one step. It's just like referring your friends or colleagues. So it is trying to create me the profile. So I have my analyst Power BI services account created within few minutes. Now let's try to deploy our report. Now you see there is nothing will be the dashboard reports. Everything is empty. Now let us try to deploy our first report that we have created. So once you are signed in, let us try to deploy this report in Power BI service, and we will view this report in Power BI service. Let's try that. For that, either you can sign in here or you can click on publish. That will prompt you to sign in, then give your ID, email ID, and click on sign in. Then enter the password. It's not your office password, it is the login password that just we have created. Now it will show you what are the workspaces available. You have only my workspace. If you've seen here, there is no other workspaces. You can create workspaces. Let us understand it better in other videos. Now let me choose this workspace, then click select. Now it's trying to publish my report, this entire Power BI report, into the service, that is cloud. Now we are in. Either you can click here or you can go and refresh your page. There you go. You can see your first dashboard reports here. Now let's click on here. Let's see your report in on cloud. So now we got the report in cloud. I hope you like this video, and share and subscribe to the channel. And comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.